All right, okay. We are here with the Ensoniq EPS16 Plus, my favorite sampler, and part of the Ensoniq trilogy, which amounts to the EPS Classic, the original EPS, this, the EPS16 Plus, and the ASR-10. What we're about to look at today is B32 of the Carpenters Sawdust, which is applicable to all the trilogy samplers. Now, before we even get started, today is a big day in addition to what we're doing now. Appendix 1.4.1 of the ASR-10 Beginners Manual is out right now. If you are already enrolled in it, it's already added to your manual. You just go to the manual and it's there. The appendix 1.4.1 is part of a series of editions that I do with information that's too small for a complete update, but relevant enough that you need to know it. If you own any Ensoniq Trilogy sampler, the ASR-10 Beginner's Manual is for you. Don't be fooled by the name. It starts out from beginner's level and takes you to complete advanced level. Info in the description box below at the Daydream Sound website. Now, on to what we're doing today. Today we are talking about the Carpenter's Sawdust. What is that? Well, it's this right here. The Carpenter's Sawdust is a floppy disk. Original things. For the Ensoniq Trilogy samplers, it is a group of waveforms made from found sounds that will expand the synthesis capabilities or enhance or give you wonderful reasons to explore the mass amount of synthesis power that's in these Ensoniq samplers. At the very least, these sounds are crazy. So B31 is what we're looking at today, and it is described as a 2+1 random panoramic monophonic waveform. That's a lot. Let me explain before we even get started. This is a three-layer waveform consisting of a root and an octave. That's your two. And then a third completely different waveform on top of that all, rounding out the complete patch. So we've spoken before as this being a 32 waveform disc, but there are waveforms such as B31 that consist of more than one waveform. So you're getting a lot of waveforms in addition to what you already have in each designated waveform just for fun. Great value. Now, let's move on to the user tips. Modulation wheel will open up a two-pole low-pass filter, adding a sharp, shrill character to this overall waveform. Furthermore, there's more. Aftertouch is in control of adding tremolo to the waveform. So there's a lot going on here. So we're going to listen to it and we're going to break it down as we go. Let's take a listen. So you hear the random panoramic. That is that bottom waveform, the extra one that I'm talking about. That pans while the two octave interval top ones stay static. So let's take a listen to what these are built off of. So let's listen to the top waveform. And of course, with Ensoniq samplers, you can access layers through the patch select button. So we're going to do that here. Top layer. Bottom layer. Top and bottom together. All three. So you have a lot of things that you could play. If you just want to deal with something that is not so as atonal or dissonant as all three, right? You can play in a key just using the octave intervals. If you want to play higher up, but not necessarily move higher up, you could just use the top part of the octave. Bottom part of the octave. Of course, all three. So there's a whole lot of variation in this one patch. Now, we haven't even gotten to the mod wheel yet. Let's see how it opens up. gets pretty squishy and pretty nice. Now let's take a look at the tremolo with the aftertouch. So much stuff, eh? Check this out. So there's a lot going on in here. And one thing I do like to mention that I really, really like about these Ensoniq samplers, because they're made in different times, you get different sound qualities based on these sounds being loaded up into either one. I found that the EPS Classic, of all things, actually has a real sort of wholesome sound, you know, really, you know, sort of dense coming out of it. Of course, you get the coldness and the just that sort of just unnerving digital warmth, if you could add the two together, in the EPS 16 Plus. And of course, the ASR-10 is just butter all the way. It's smoothness. So let us, as always, and this one, we're going to try some delay and see what we get. Check it out. So nice. So many variations in one thing. If you would like to know more of the details, if you like to read up on specifications and that sort of thing, you can do so with the Carpenter Sawdust Patch Guide Manual, which is free at the Daydream Sound Manual section. You could look through it and see if this is the sort of ideal thing for you. However, if you already own an EPS Classic, EPS 16 Plus, or ASR-10, and you yet do not have the Carpenter Sawdust, what on earth are you waiting for? Take yourself down to the Daydream Sound General Store and get yourself sorted. On a side note, this November coming up, November 2022, and expect the new album from yours truly. More news to come. That is all I wanted to share with you today. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.